I know that you are thinking as a young software developer, why should I learn the C language? Probably you see at the job market, and there is a huge request for Python, for JavaScript, for Rust, perhaps it starts to build some requests. So why to spend the efforts of learning the C language if there are little jobs and probably in the future there could be less and less jobs about C. I think there are a couple of very strong reasons in order to learn C. Let's start for the fundamental one. C has a very, very good return over investment because the time you spend learning the language is very small compared to what you can do once you know the C language. However, don't take me wrong. I'm not saying that it's very easy to become an expert C programmer, but the language itself is extremely small. It's extremely fast to learn. What is the best C book, C language book, which is the KNR, starts with an introduction that says something like C is a small language, so it is well served by a small book. And indeed, it's a very small book, but it's a very dense book. It's a synopsis of a lot of ideas about the C language and also about certain things about operating systems, allocators. KNR is really a gem, even if it is a very old book at this point. And C is very, very similar. So C is very small language, easy to learn. But once you learn it, you realize that there is something magic about C because it is a very low level language to the point that you can sometimes, especially in the old times where computer processors were easy, you could think, oh, this C section is probably going to be translated into this assembly code. Now it's more complicated than that. Sometimes you write a for loop and then it is translated to seamed parallel instructions and so forth. But anyway, the point is that C in some way is extremely low level, but you often realize that once you start to put together structures and function pointers, you can build abstractions more and more over the low-level ground of C, and you end with something that looks extremely high level. So in some way, when you write C software which is well designed, the first layer is to build a new language in order to use this new language, which is composed of function and abstractions you made in C, in order to write, to use this new higher level language to write your application. And that's super cool. It's really something magical about C to be able to be so low level and so high level at the same time. Another good reason for learning C is that the effort so is small to learn C, but on the other side, the code base is huge. The code that you can read and modify and hack if you have some C fluency is huge. Imagine pretending to be a great hacker, not able to modify the Linux kernel, not able to understand the Python interpreter implementation. I don't want to say that there aren't very good programmers that don't know C. But if you want to be a hacker, somebody that understands systems in general, you have to know how to modify the Linux kernel, or if you have a Linux kernel file, you have to understand what it says, how things are happening, and so forth. Probably now it is also very interesting to be able to use AI to learn new languages. So even if I must admit there are a couple of new books about C, this is true, but I never stumbled upon something which is so good as the original KNDR book. However, it is possible to take a very good old language book and companion it with ChatGPT or Claude or whatever you want in order to understand what's outdated, what you should know that the book could never cover, and so forth. So for also there is another very very interesting question about learning C. In order to understand some certain things that otherwise are very synthetic about modern languages, for example, to explain the borrow checker in Rust without understanding what's the problem in general is very 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 hard without learning C. Another thing that I believe it's true is that to understand all the shortcomings in Rust, for example, it's very hard if you don't know C. If you the first many many people are exposed as a first low-level language to Rust, so they believe that Rust is a language which is important since it needs safety, but at the same time is a language which doesn't scale down. Normally, it's a good abstraction is one where to do simple things is simple, and then to do harder things is harder, but you can do it. Rust is a language that doesn't scale down, and sometimes trivial things are extremely hard to obtain. If you learn C, then you understand which is the compromise in Rust or in Zig or in Go or whatever. If you don't learn C, you don't really acquire this full perspective in order to evaluate the other things. So learning C is fast, learning C has a good return over investment. Go learn C. Bye.